Yes. So our chapter today is The Black Aeroplane by Frederick Forsyth. The chapter deals with certain things that a man is traveling from France to England to meet his family. And before going into the chapter, we will look for some of the objectives that we have to keep in mind while reading this chapter. The first objective is understanding the plot of the whole story, that what the plot deals with, what are the various kind of descriptions, what are the various kind of images that the author has used, and also the mystery element that has been used in this story. Number two is we have to evaluate its relation to real life incidents. We will evaluate its relation, the relation of this kind of mysterious things in our life to the real life experiences of many people. Number three is to analyze the emotional elements in the story. There are certain or many emotional elements in the story. We would try to analyze those emotional elements in the story. Once again, I'll have to go back and just give entry to some person who is already here. No, there is nobody, I think. Yes, it is. Okay. So moving back to the slideshow again. So we will go through understanding the plot and then evaluating its relation to the real life. And number three, analyzing the emotional elements in the story. And number four is we would justify the importance of mental strength. Whenever stuck in any kind of problem, the one thing that we all need is mental strength. As we have also learned in the previous chapter of the first flight of the seagull, the mental strength has been tested. The mental strength of the seagull has been tested. Number five is we have to remember the various important meanings and situations, the new words also that we come across while reading the chapter. And number six, form our own answers and write them properly. So, okay, so through the chapter, we are going to opt to learn these various objectives. Now, coming to the story. The story relates a pilot who is flying a Dakota plane, Dakota DS-088 plane, toward from France to England to reach his family, which is in England, and he's very longing to have his breakfast with his family at England or in London. So he is flying. The story starts with him flying from over the countryside of France and then over Paris. You can see a plane flying over Paris. As you can see the Eiffel Tower over there. Paris is a very planned city. If you can even see from top of the Eiffel Tower, you can reach up till here. You can see this place, small place over here, this tower. People can actually visit there and see the whole city of Paris from there. And it looks very much organized from up there. So the plane was flying from above Paris and was trying to reach England. And suddenly it was almost getting night, and there was no cloud in the sky. The sky was very clear, and the pilot could see the moon behind him very clear, and the city lighted below his eyesight. And it's a very beautiful sight. There is no cloud at all. The sky was very clear. Okay, and what happened then? He was actually flying a Dakota DS-088. Please remember this name. The name of the plane that he was flying was Dakota DS-088. And he was flying from France to England. And he has flown over the countryside of France and the main city of Paris to navigate his way to England. Then what happens, the map and the compass along with the condition of fuel tank was everything fine. Everything was running very fine. He was going fine on his track. Only the fuel was running a little low. Otherwise, it was everything fine. So what happened? Suddenly he found black clouds of storm, which were like huge black mountains all around, gathering all around the plane. Suddenly, all of a sudden, there was almost a storm and black clouds, which were as huge as black mountains, crumbling up alongside the aeroplane. And he was obviously getting nervous, because usually this kind of black storm clouds can create a lot of danger for a flying aeroplane. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. When it reached inside the cloud, it was completely pitch dark inside the cloud. Nothing could be seen. And the old aeroplane started jumping and twisting and spinning inside the air or the air pockets or the clouds over there. Okay. And it was complete dark. There was lightning and nothing could be seen. Obviously, the condition of the pilot, we can very well imagine. Then what happened? Suddenly he finds that another aeroplane with no lights on the wings appeared just beside the aeroplane, the Dakota DS-088, which our pilot is riding. There was another aeroplane which was just beside him, but there was no lights on the wings of the aeroplane. It looked like a black aeroplane. But though the plane was not visible, I couldn't find enough appropriate pictures for that. But he could definitely see the pilot who was waving back at the author or the pilot over here. And slowly he turned his plane towards north as if indicating our pilot, the author pilot, to follow him. And as if that pilot over there in that black aeroplane have got a clear idea that the author over here or the pilot over here is lost. And he's trying to navigate his way towards the right track. And he went in front of the author's flight and he moved or turned his plane towards north as if to show a little person how to go, as if showing a way to the plane. Suddenly, as they were stuck, it was complete dark and the compass was also not working. There was no radar correction with the control room. He tried to call the control room of France because he wanted to return, because there was no other way that he could reach England and he wanted to return back to Paris. He tried to control the Paris control room of the airport, but there was no connection, no radar activities, and the fuel was also symboling empty. Okay, there was a fuel deficit in the plane, but he went on following that black aeroplane, which very confidently took him through the dark clouds. Suddenly, after a few twists and turns, he suddenly found himself coming out from the black clouds and he found in front of him, below him, he saw two straight lines which were lighted and seemed something like an airport landing. Okay, so you can see here how it looks, the airport landing, how it looks with the lights on. So the poet found himself near the airport landing, and when he looked back, the black aeroplane was not there. Okay, he immediately went to the control room of that airport and he wanted to send a thank note to the pilot of the black aeroplane. Obviously, he has saved his life, so he wanted to send a thank you note to the black aeroplane. Maybe through the control room, he can just talk to him and say that he was really thankful. But the control room said that there was no other aeroplanes over there, and the radar was only catching the signal for his aeroplane. And in this kind of stormy weather, there was absolutely no chance of any other aeroplane in that area. So if the author has seen any other aeroplane, it was completely his own imagination, as there was no other aeroplane in that area at that time. That is what the control room said. So obviously this remained a mystery for the pilot, who has actually seen the pilot waving at him and taking him out of the storm. So I would even narrate, these are some of the mysterious incidents that it will be O-N-E-1, okay. So there are many such mysterious incidents where people hallucinated whenever in complete tension or in high altitude. People has hallucinated that some other person is guiding them throughout the problem. I would show you some of the real examples of such mysterious incidents. I have some examples written over here from some original people. Some years ago, while climbing in thin air, I met a man who wasn't there. I had climbed solo to the mountain peak of Aconcagua in Argentina Andes. Being fit and foolish, I had climbed too rapidly for the adequate acclimatization to occur. So this man was climbing towards the mountain peak of Aconcagua in Argentina, which is the Andes range. Okay, and he was very fit and foolish. And usually we make this mistake that even in the 7-lap relay races or 7-lap tenacity races, even in the marathons, those who are fit and fine, they think that we will run faster than the others. And in the beginning, they run very fast, or the beginning they climb very fast in the mountain. At the end, they get exhausted. Because this kind of acclimatization means we are not acclimatized. Acclimatized means we are not acquainted. I'm using one after the other tough words. I mean, we are not ready to accept the environmental condition and make our body like that. Okay. Say, for example, if you go for a trekking, you would be, for the first 2 days, you would be sent for acclimatization trip. Acclimatization over here means your body should be adequate to adjust with the climatic condition and the high altitude rise if you are going from the plain to the mountains. That is called acclimatization. So this man, what he did, he climbed to the mountain very fast and he to get an acclimatization properly. Then what happens, as I staggered down from the 22,831 feet summit, frostbitten, exhausted and alone, I felt the powerful sensation of being accompanied by somebody. I turned around repeatedly to look for the other person, but there was nobody to be seen on the wind-swept slopes. I kept descending, feeling in some strange way as if I were floating slightly above my body. My invisible companion following behind me, encouraging me to keep on going. Lower down the mountain, I felt stronger and my follower disappeared as mysteriously as he had arrived. This is said by Paul Firth, who is one of the very renowned mountaineers. So you can see what he has said, that when he was coming down or climbing up, he had seen somebody, he has felt that somebody is accompanying him. And this is nothing new. And when he moved down, when he gained his confidence back again, he found that that person has disappeared. And this is not something that is very unique. This has been said by many of the scientists and doctors and psychoanalysts, that in high altitude and in many places of distress or struggle, people hallucinate that some person is giving them strength or encouraging them to do some kind of work. Even the people who climb Mount Everest, I would give one more example of Mount Everest, then I will also tell you one of my own stories. This example is, in the extreme altitudes, mountaineers often mention experiencing psychosis, that is a mental disorder where a person becomes out of touch with reality. Symptoms of psychotic episodes include hallucination and delusions. Hallucinations and delusions mean when you imagine something that is actually not present over there. For instance, when mountaineer and anesthetist Mr. Jeremy Windsor was climbing Mount Everest in 2008, he underwent a strong experience common in extreme mountaineering. Alone in the Himalayas at an altitude of more than 5.1 million, Windsor hallucinated a man called Jimmy, who accompanied him all day long, spoke encouraging words to him, and then vanished without a trace. So over here, the mountaineer Jeremy has actually experienced that a man called Jimmy is following him and speaking to him with encouraging words. And suddenly when he gained his consciousness or his strength or his confidence, this man named Jimmy disappeared. And this is not the only story in mountaineering or in other cases. There are many other stories. Even you all must have heard about that little girl who has climbed the mountain. She also felt that her elder sister is accompanying her to the top of the mountain. And not only in the cases of mountain, but there are many other cases where we hallucinate things. Even in our stressed situations, even during the time of our exams, when we are typically stressed and we have to stay awake all night, we hallucinate many things. We feel that somebody is around us, but not very encouragingly. We actually feel it very in a spooky sense. But for the mountaineers, it is the high altitude, and maybe for the pilot of the black aeroplane, the high altitude has again taken its toll. So these are the two important and interesting experiences that I wanted, that I've read and I wanted to share with you, which related a lot with the incident of the black aeroplane. Okay, now coming to the major points that you have to remember. Remember that when you are going through this video again, you have to write down these important points in your notebook. So I'll just go through the important points first. The story Black Aeroplane is about a pilot who feels happy and contented to fly over a city that is sleeping at the night. He is flying from Paris to London. Please remember this. While taking his flight, he dreams about a long holiday with his family. He also fantasizes about the scrumptious breakfast he would have upon landing with his family. As soon as he crosses Paris, he gets a look of the dark clouds that were a sign of the upcoming storm. The right decision would have been to turn back to Paris for the sake of safety. Obviously, if he would have turned back to Paris, it would have been more safe. Next, but he, being overshadowed by the dreams and not wanting to delay them, risks the life of his passengers and heads straight into the storm. Now, this is very silly according to me. For a sumptuous breakfast with the family, you are risking the life of the passengers and yourself. This is a bit silly for me. Then it is, everything gets dark all around him. He is unable to see, all his directions, instructions stopped functioning, and he lost the control of the plane. As I have told you, all the functions of the plane, the fuel was deficit over there, the radar was not working, the compass was not working, the map was not working, nothing was working over there in the control room. When all hope was lost, he saw another plane whose pilot was more than willing to rescue them. The author was panicking as there was very less amount of fuel left. The anonymous pilot guided them out of the storm and disappeared as soon as they saw light. Upon landing, when he asks the lady in the control room about other pilot who was in the black plane, he is left in shock when she says that his was the only plane in the sky. So what happens over here? I'm just summarizing this again to you. Black Aeroplane is a story which tells us that there is a very happy-go-lucky kind of a pilot who is traveling from Paris to London, from Paris to London to meet his family, and he is dreaming and fantasizing to have a sumptuous breakfast with his family in London, and for that he's ready to even die. For a breakfast, a London English breakfast, he is even ready to die over here. As soon as he crosses Paris, he could see the dark clouds, which were almost like huge black mountains, were gathering around him. Okay, and he immediately he got nervous and he wanted to return back to Paris again. But the control room of the Paris was not giving any answer back, as he has lost every connection with the control room. The compass, the map was not working. Even the fuel condition was not good. And what did he was not ready to leave up his dreams, and there was no other way than risking the life of the passengers and going straight into the storm. And just as he went inside the storm, the black clouds became even darker, and there was nothing except darkness all around him. He was unable to see any direction. The instruments of the cockpit or the instruments of the control panel in front of him stopped working, and he was completely freaked out. Okay, and when he lost all hope, he saw another plane whose pilot was willing to help him out. He waved him and he wanted to show the way from where he could go. The pilot went in front of him, the pilot took the black aeroplane in front of the author's aeroplane, and he showed him the way out through the clouds. And when he came out from the clouds, he found that the aeroplane landing pad is over there, and the lights lit in a straight line, and he landed over there. And immediately as he landed over there, he went to the control room, and there was a lady sitting over there, and he wanted to send a thank you note to the aeroplane of the black the pilot of the black aeroplane. But to the shock of him, he realized the control person said that there was no other aeroplane in that in the area except his, because of the heavy storm. So he was completely shocked. So the story poses for us a very mysterious element, like hallucination, which we have discussed that even many of the mountaineers in high altitude, they experience hallucinations. As we have, I have shown you the direct conversation of some who are climbing the mountains of Argentina, and they feel that some person is encouraging them and forcing them to move up, and as soon as they regain their consciousness and their confidence, that person vanishes completely. And the doctors also have confirmed that due to high altitude and extreme mental pressure, sometimes human beings have seen hallucinating this kind of things. Even in Mount Everest also, we have several this kind of incidents, as I have just told you about Jeremy Windsor, who has seen somebody named Jimmy, who was following him up to the top of the mountain and back. And as soon as he came back with the encouraging words of Jimmy, he found Jimmy disappearing somewhere. And then later he realized that it was no person, it was completely his hallucination. And there are many such cases of hallucinations. Okay, so black aeroplane gives us a very strong impact and a very strong message that whatever be the situation, whatever be our mental stress, sometimes we are the only help that we have got. Maybe that's the only help, that there was no black aeroplane obviously. So the pilot's mind was only helping him up, and only positive people's mind can hallucinate such positive things. Otherwise you would collapse up there. Only those people who are extremely positive, like the mountaineers to the Mount Everest, like over there that man who was going up the Argentina mountains, or over here the pilot who is fighting through the storm to reach his home or reach his loved ones. Only the passionate positive minds can hallucinate such positive encouragement and hallucinate such positive reinforcement to reach their direction or to reach their destiny. That is what we come across in this story. So I hope that one second, I'll stop sharing my screen and I'll even stop the recording.